What up, YouTube? It's Kurt here. We're going to take a look at Endymion. All right, so this deck is brand new, and the cards just came out in the structure deck, and obviously a lot of people picked them up pretty much for their droll on Lockbirds, which are only $4 now, which is pretty awesome. I really like that. But other than that, we're going to take a look at Endymion and how it's going to function as a deck and whether or not it will be meta. So to save you guys some time, I'm going to go ahead and answer that question. Will it be meta? My opinion is no, it will not be meta. It will be good. It will be a good rogue strategy, but it will not be meta. I think it'll be about the same tier as what something like Trickstars are in. And we'll go ahead and evaluate why. All right, so Endymion obviously is pendulums, and the weird thing is, like, you can play some cool hybrids with it. A lot of people are going the Mystical Beast hybrid, and that's perfectly fine. There's some cool things you can do with it. The ending ward, you can sometimes end on both Jackal. You can both end on both Jackal and your Master Endymion, and that's actually a really good play. But the thing is, this deck really struggles against losing resources. One, it doesn't really have room to play hand traps. You basically need to play spells in order to get like 3 spell counters on things, and that runs into trouble sometimes. In order to get those spell counters, that can kind of eat up your resources a little bit. So say you're dealing, you almost have to play Pot of Desires to make it playable. So say you play Pot of Desires, you start your opening hand of 5. Well, then you would want to probably set a spell first. You set one of your pendulum cards to get the counters off. Then you play Pot of Desires. This gets ashed. Well, crap, all of a sudden, your resources are bland. You may not even have the ability to get Endymion out on the board on that point. And if you get ashed with one of your search effects, well, that's also like, that also can put you in a very bad spot. So a lot of times, if you get ashed, the game's just not looking very good just from that hand trap alone. Droll and Lockbird, kind of, like, if you do a terraforming, you get droll locked, well, that's gonna hurt you a little bit as well. Don't get me wrong, Endymion is a great freaking card, but it's a 1-negate destroy, and then Jackal is a 1-negate destroy, and when your monsters are destroyed, they really do get good effects when they're destroyed. But other than that, if you kind of ignore your opponent's back row, and just focus on control at that point, I think Endymions will be pretty easy to handle. They're one of those decks that can end on something kind of, I would almost say borderline gimmicky, in the fact that, oh, they get some cool negates, they get a lot of spell counters, they get some nice recursion effects. But the thing is, it's like, if you nip them in the bud, they almost have no backup plan. That's what the problem with Endymion is. If you go full board, it's a great deck, but if you don't go full board and you get any sort of brick and your opponent does any sort of interruptions to you, you're going to have a very hard time with things. So that's what's going to happen. So we'll just talk about deck profiles. Oh, there's Abduction. Yeah, Abduction is almost necessary. This is a build I think I've seen from Samurai, whatever the guy's name is. Probably not my favorite YouTuber, but he does videos. I mean, that's cool. And I did just look at this because he's like, I got a budget build. There's probably a much better build than this, but there are some cool things you do with this. A lot of times you want to search Jackal. Honestly, if you get Jackal on field and you get Master Endymion, yeah, then things are, or whatever his TCGM is, your board's looking pretty good. But you can't afford to play hand traps, and you can get hand trapped pretty well, and that's the inherent problem of the deck. So feel free, I'll scroll over these cards so you can see what I'm playing. Go ahead and slow down the video if you need to, but most of these cards are structured deck cards that you get. I play Upstart Goblin. Then, let's see, you have a couple Mythical Beast Engine cards there. We went... Yeah, the Supreme King mini engine is kind of okay. and Foolish Burial for that, and then Jackal and Space Typhoon. So there's probably better builds that you could make out of this. Maybe there's a better hybrid you can make, but as far as right now, I don't think Endymion will be a tier 1 or tier 2 threat. We're looking at tier 3 or lower, depending on how you define your tiers. All right, so that's all I got, guys. Peace out.